Hello fellow YouTubers, it's me again, and today's toy review was going to be on another figure I just recently purchased, the old Bandai Telesdon, from the series in the 2000 line. The repaint is out now, and you can get it. It's part of the new EX series, because he's not like a game character. He just comes with like, I think a folded tag, but he doesn't come with a trading card. This one, of course, is actually a repaint of a previous figure. The first, like, vintage Bandai Telesdon was, like, you know, all gold and maybe some slight different highlights. This one, of course, is made, you know, with a really dark, well, not, it's not black, but a really dark brown vinyl, and with shades of kind of like a bronze, you know, color on it. Looks really neat, and mine has red in the mouth. As you can see, I think that was done by a previous owner because I've seen others and they don't have that, so it makes my figure a little more unique. He's got a few scratches, but he's in very good condition, you know, considering his age. Here's the tag he came with. Tag is in pretty good condition as well. Got a little scratch there or whatever. Picture of the suit. He's number 57 in the 2000 series. Telesdon. He's 60 meters tall, 12,000 tons. It's folded, of course. Show you guys. No footprint. That's kind of unusual. But anyway, let's go on to articulation. He's pretty basic. His arms can move 360, of course. Just like this. So you can have him up here, you know, like this. Down here, flat and straight. In the air. Whatever you want to do. The arms are pretty stubby, and what's really cool about his arms, or the hands at least, they look an awful lot like Red King's. Here, let me get him out here. As you can see, you know, just the hands. They look very similarly designed, like maybe they took Red King's hands, or vice versa, and used them for the characters. Speaking of which, as you can see, he's 60 meters tall, and Red King's like 40-something, so this isn't very accurate. Yeah. Just wanted to point that out. I'll get to more scaling later. So yeah, the arms can rotate 360 degrees, no problem. He is soft vinyl, so he's very squishy, which is kind of weird because he's such an old figure. Also switch the mouth. One thing I really like about the mouth, unlike the new repaint that's out, the teeth are actually individually painted, which is kind of, you know, like the new one, they're like all brown like the head, and the eyes are cool. The new one has blue eyes. I like the black eyes better, and that's really cool about this figure. The teeth are all individually sculpted. That's really, really neat. And anyway, yeah, legs can rotate just like this. Rotate. So yeah. And there's a glue seal at the tail if you break it, which is kind of easy because, you know, he's not like super soft vinyl. It can turn just like this. One thing that is kind of disappointment is the spike on his back. They've molded it into his back. You know, the spike here is supposed to protrude outward more like this, but, you know, they didn't do that, of course. So yeah, let's go to scaling now. I already showed you Red King, who's 40 meters. Now let's try Gomora, who is also 40 meters, or about that size. This is alright. Again, Telesdon's like 60 meters, Gomora's not 60 meters. He's 40, but okay. Let's see, let's bring out Ultraman. Good old Ultraman. Again, not accurate. Telesdon's 60 meters, Ultraman's 40. So Ultraman shouldn't be bigger. He actually is bigger. Alright, yeah, that's about it, because he fought, you know, Ultraman in the, actually, I'll tell him that story. Let's try good old Naranga now. This seems okay. I forget how tall Naranga is. I think he's like 40 meters or something. I'd have to check the tag again, but yeah. Let me get the 1960 Godzilla, which, you know, a lot of you have, which is pretty common, so you can get an idea of his size. This is a pretty okay sizing. Let's move it back here. Yeah, Godzilla's 50 meters, Telesdon 60, so this isn't too far-fetched. Now, in terms of history, well, let me get to his detail first. Figure is actually very well detailed, if you can believe that. Like, it looks like a simple figure, but it's not. It has all sorts of little bumps and scratches and scrapes on the body that are on the suit, actually. Like, on the chest here, just look at that. Just look at these here. That's some fine craftsmanship. Back is not as detailed. It's more like, you know, the smooth surfaces and stuff. But it's pretty cool. And again, I love how the teeth are all individually sculpted. Well, let's see. Well, for the most part, the top bar, they have, you know, a little more vinyl in them, but the bottom is completely individual. So, yeah. Okay. Now, on to his history real quick. Telesdon first appeared in the original Ultraman again. I forget what episode it was. I think it was roughly episode 22, I think? I don't know. I forgot. Anyway, I haven't been able to watch most of the episode because, well, when I was looking for the episode at the time, I was just looking for Telesdon Roars. I kind of skipped through it, and basically, I guess what I gathered is there are a race of people underground, and they got some kind of problem with the people above ground, and so they send their monster Telesdon to, you know, do the usual, smash up cities for whatever reason. And they're very sensitive to light. I guess, you know, Hayate uses that. You know, they capture him somehow. He uses that and goes up to fight as Ultraman after transforms and beats them. I don't know. You'd have to look up the episode on VO.com or something like that. Anywho. So, yeah, he fights Telesdon. It's a pretty long battle, actually, and Telesdon's a pretty good fighter. But he eventually kills him. And I don't think he uses his Specium Ray. I forget. But yeah, he kills Telesdon, he just kind of keels over and dies, and that's it. Telesdon also appeared in Ultraman Powered, or Ultraman the Ultimate Hero, with roughly the same story. And they used his hypersensitivity to light against him, giving Ultraman enough time to kind of kill him with his, what you call it? I think they call it the Giga Specium Ray or the Mega Specium Ray. I think it's a Mega, so yeah. Yeah, it's Mega Specium Ray. Anywho, yeah. Kills Telesdon pretty easily. The design in that show was kind of weird because his face just looked really, it kind of looked kind of awkward, like his face had a mask on almost. And the spike on his back looked more like wings, almost. Anywho, yeah. He didn't appear later. He appeared in Ultraman Jack. Well, sort of. The suit did. What they did was they took the Telesdon suit, they converted it into a new monster called Deton. D-E-T-T-O-N. Deton, or something like that. All it was a fatter Telesdon with a big nose and different eyes, and that was it. It's pretty poor. It even still had the spike on the back. But anyway, yeah. He also appeared in Ultra Galaxy, you know, the first series and the second series. First series, he appeared, let's see. He appeared in the first episode along with Sidora, who I fortunately don't have, which sucks because I love that, you know, I don't like Sidora that much, but I love the figure. Yeah, he appeared with Sidora and Red King and Gomora. Telesdon was getting his ass kicked by Red King after he fought with Sidora for a while, who got killed by Red King. So basically, Red King was beating on both of them. Eventually, Telesdon and Red King stopped fighting, broke up, and Telesdon burrowed in the ground to escape. And in the second episode, Telesdon came back, except this time he was joined by Golza. So yeah. So you probably are guessing what happened already. Golza got killed by Gomora. Whoosh. And Telesdon got killed by Gomora as well. He appeared in Ultra Galaxy Neo for a short time under the control of Zetton Seijin. And he was fighting against alien Hook's monster, Dorako, or Revived Dorako. They fought for a while, and it was a throwback to the old episode where Dorako fought Telesdon in another episode of Ultraman, which I forgot to mention. Yeah, he was revived by Geronimon in another episode, and he fought Dorako for a little bit. Then for whatever reason, they stopped fighting, and they were eventually both killed by the Science Patrol before Geronimon was killed by Ultraman. In another episode of Ultra Galaxy, the first series, he was revived, so that's three times in one series, by Bolton, along with Naronga, and Red King here, to fight Gomora. So you've got five monsters, only a few of which I actually have, because I don't have Bolton. There isn't a Bolton, really. So in conclusion, Telesdon has a pretty good detail, like surprisingly good. You'd have to see it up close for yourself to know. Pretty decent paint job, decent articulation, especially if you're Ray DeLucio. He's pretty big, and he's just really neat. That's been my review. I hope you guys like it. Telesdon is going to get a 4 out of 5. I give him the score because he's not completely accurate, of course. But, you know, I did that. I got him on my own. So yeah, that's been my review, and I hope you guys liked it. So I'll see you guys later.